Hello guys. Good afternoon. Hi, Mr. Paul. How are you today?
Hello.
How are you doing?
Good.
Hello, Paul. How are you?
Hello, teacher.
Ready for today, Paul? Hi, Elena. How are you today?
Hi, teacher. Good, thank you. And you?
I'm good, thank you. Are you ready for today?
Yes, teacher. No le pude
Yes.
mandar los audios porque no tenía tanto internet, no tenía la señal bien.
Ah, okay. ¿Me los vas a enviar?
Yes, ahorita después de la clase se lo voy a dar.
Okay, today.
Yes.
Okay. Hi, Emiliano.
Hi, teacher. How are you today?
Good. How are you today, Mister?
Good, teacher.
Very nice. Ready for class? Ready, ready.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, guys. Well, let's continue with the class from yesterday, which it was was a review. Remember, we were reviewing these two topics, simple past and present perfect. And we will do, vamos a rehacer, porque recuerden que no nos fue muy bien en el tema este, este de aquí, página 13. ¿Ok? Escribieron con pluma. Hay que borrarlo, a ver si lo podemos rehacer de nuevo el día de hoy. Okey-dokey. Si no, hacerlo en un cuaderno porque, pues, it was difficult. All right? So we're gonna do it today. So, let's go with the information, okay? Simple past and present perfect. Yesterday we talked about the positive yesterday. Yesterday we did the positive and yesterday we did the negative. And yesterday we did the positive and yesterday we did the negative, right? For simple past and for present perfect. Now, for example, can you, Paul, give me a sentence in present perfect? You remember the formula for that? Remember, you
In
need the
present perfect.
auxiliary in there? Exactly, yes.
Positive or negative?
Positive, please.
I have earphones.
I have, give me the verb. Acuérdate que es
I have
earphones. I have
como earphones. ¿Cómo se puede escuchar?
earphones. I
With
have,
earphones.
okay. I have heard. He escuchado. Like that?
Yes.
Okay. I have heard with earphones. Okay. He escuchado con audífonos. I have heard with earphones. Okay. Now, if you go with a simple past, right, which is going to do the regular you know, the regular conjugation in past, which is going to be I, for example, went to the park yesterday. All right, in here we have no complications. We have the conjugation of the verb. All right, but yesterday we talked about the negative also, and we said something like this: I didn't go to the park yesterday. And in the negative, for the example that Paul gave me, I have heard. I'm going to say, I haven't heard. No he escuchado. I haven't heard with earphones. Okay. So this is what we did yesterday. The positives and the negatives. Positive, positive, negative, negative. Today, we need to go with the questions. All right. Hi, Mr. Jesus. How are you today?
Hello, teacher. I'm fine, thank you.
Doing good, man. Thank you. Doing good. All right. So what we need to do for questions today, because the class is going to be about that, simple past, this is what we need to complete, okay? So imagine that you have, in this case, we have that element yet, right? Now, if you think about, where is it? I'm going to put it over here. If you think about the formula for you to have questions, porque las vamos a ocupar ahorita, questions, right? Let's go with a simple past formula. The simple past is going to be the WH word and then the auxiliary, the subject, and then the verb in base form, okay?
Hi, teacher.
Hi, Evelyn, how are you today?
I'm fine, thank you.
Excellent, I'm good, thank you. And the complement, right? That will be the formula for the simple past. Okay? Now, think about, because this is very important, think about that in the complement, sorry, excuse me. In the complement, we need the time expression. Right? Esto lo hemos repetido y repetido y repetido. Time expression, right? So, what time expressions are going to be common? Because this is going to be the important part. Something like yesterday, something like last year. We understand this one. Last week, you know? Anything that represents the past, esto también ya lo explicamos, right? Y aquí es donde viene la complejidad, quizá, del tema, right? So, I'm gonna go with something like this. Where, auxiliary, did, subject, where did you, verb, where did you study, complement, where did you study, for the exam, right? And time expression, yesterday. Where did you study for the exam yesterday? Where did you study for the exam yesterday? Paulette, how can you answer this? How are you, Paulette?
You I think didn't. You can...
Uh-huh.
I did study for the exam in my house.
I did study for the exam at my house. Okay, Now, in this case, Paulette, look, what we're going to do, this date over here, all right, we're going to eliminate it. You're going to get the study verb in this case, and you're going to put it in past. Studied, and we eliminate the did, right? I studied in past for the exam at my house. All right? So we do the conjugation in here. Correct? So this is the formula for simple past, right? Let's go with the formula for present perfect. There you go. It's gonna be WH auxiliary. What is the auxiliary for present perfect? Subject. Have. Thank you, mister. Or we have to remember has subject and then the verb and then the complement. Everything is the same. Time expression. Time expression. There you go. Okay. We can do where or why have auxiliary, you subject, where have you, why have you, I'm sorry, why have you. Why have you bought that cell phone? Why have you bought that cell phone? This week, I'm going to say. ¿Por qué has comprado ese celular? ¿Por qué has comprado ese celular esta semana, right? And not this, not next week, probably. Hi, Angie. How are you? Right.
Ay, teacher, can... Sorry por conectarme tan tarde. Es que tengo mucha tarea y la verdad no me di cuenta de la hora.
Don't worry, Angie. Are you ready now?
Yes.
Excellent. Let's do it then. So we have the verb and then the complement, right? We said that one. Why have you bought that cell phone this week? It can be something like, where have you, right? Where have you traveled this year? ¿A dónde has viajado este año, right? Okay, so that's what we have. We have the two formulas. We need to understand. It's point number one, right? We need to understand if my question is simple past or if my question is present perfect. That is the first thing that we need to understand. Okay? So let's see. Página 13, right? Vamos a rehacer este ejercicio, como lo dijimos. Page number 13, which is this one. Okay? Si ya lo tienen, hay que borrarlo. O vayamos checando si lo tienen bien. Okay? All right. So, let's go with the first reactive in here. Okay. It says, mother, I want to prepare dinner. Oh, the mother is the stocking, right? I want to prepare dinner. And then we have this specific word, yet. So, yet, you're going to connect it with simple past, or you're going to connect it with present perfect. Hmm? With what word? I mean, with what conjugation tense? Simple past or present perfect?
Present perfect.
Present perfect, Jesus, right? Exactly. So in the information, we have the subject and we have the verb. So what is the question? It's going to be, right? What is the auxiliary for you in present perfect?
Have.
So the question is, have you, I have you in here, okay? I have that info. And then I have my verb. Have you washed? Have you washed the dishes yet? Yeah? Teacher, what page is it? Number 13, Miss Alina. All right.
Thank you.
Look at the number 2. You're welcome. Is the daughter, I the dishes yesterday. Okay, this one over here. Simple past or present perfect?
Simple past.
Simple past. My sentence is a positive sentence. So, what are you putting here? It's positive. You need to conjugate.
I have washed dishes.
I have washed the dishes. No, porque ese sería presente perfecto. I have washed. Right?
I have washed.
I have washed. No. Sin auxiliar. Right, guys? It's only this one. I washed, because it's in past. I washed the dishes yesterday, right? Dice, pero we have a negative, the time to do it today. Today, simple past or present perfect?
Present
perfect, exactly. So, what is the auxiliary for I in present perfect?
Do.
But in present perfect, that is in present only, Jesus.
Have,
exactly. So, it's negative. It's negative. So I haven't. Yo no he. Past participle of have. Past participle of have. Porque aquí tendría que ser yo no he tenido el tiempo aún. Yo no he tenido el tiempo aún. How do you say that? Yo no he tenido. Past participle of have. That is the answer. Alina.
Yo no tengo libro.
¿El libro no lo tienes?
Me mandaron a imprimir el otro.
Tienes uno equivocado, Elena. ¿Ustedes
no
sí lo
sé,
tienen, chicos?
Estaba buscando la clase. ¿No?
Es este, mira. Es this one. ¿No? This one with the castle.
No lo puedo ver.
There it is. Yep.
No.
You don't have it. Take notes then. All right, because it's a difficult exercise. Okay. Let's continue, guys. No nos podemos escapar de este ejercicio. I'm sorry. But I haven't. No he tenido. Yo no he tenido el tiempo. I haven't what? Past participle of have. Come on. Had, Alina, thank you. Had. I haven't had. Yo no he tenido el tiempo aún. Aquí lo tenemos. Aún. Yo no he tenido el tiempo aún de hacerlo hoy. ¿Hacer qué? ¿Van siguiendo la conversación? ¿Hacer qué? I haven't had the time to do what today?
Wash the dishes.
Wash the dishes. Very good. Okay. Ahí vamos, ahí vamos. Now is the mother, right? Look at this element. Already, do you connect it with simple past or do you connect it with present perfect? ¿Cómo dirían? ¿Hiciste la tarea ya o has hecho la tarea ya? Which one is better for you? ¿Ya hiciste la tarea o ya has hecho la tarea? What is good for you?
Ya hiciste.
Ya hiciste. Simple past or present perfect? Ya hiciste. Simple past or present perfect?
Simple.
Simple past, Alina, yes. Okay. Auxiliary for simple past. What is the auxiliary for simple past?
Did.
Did. Okay. Very good. So we have, did you, here we have the subject. Did you do, did you already do? Did you already do? Did you already? Did you already do your homework? ¿Ya hiciste tu tarea? Did you already do your homework? Okay, okay, okay. Look at the answer of the daughter. Did you already do your homework? The answer is no. Look. Justo acabo de, right? Home from school. Analyze it. ¿Qué dirían? ¿Justo llegué de la escuela o justo he llegado de la escuela?
¿Justo he llegado?
¿Justo he llegado de la escuela? It's possible, Evelyn. So, I have I. What is my auxiliary for present perfect?
Has and have.
Has and have. For I, what is it, Paul? I have or I has?
Has.
No, not for I.
I know have.
I have, right? Then I'm gonna put I have just, which is this one, and this one in past participle. I have just come from school. I have just come home from school. Acabo de llegar, acabo de venir a casa de la escuela, right? Okay. Let's continue with the mother. Look, 2 hours ago. Simple past or present perfect?
Simple past.
Simple past. We have a positive sentence, right? Okay. This one in past. Tú llegaste a casa hace 2 horas, le dice la mamá. Tú llegaste. Simple past. What is it? Simple past of come. Which one, Jesus?
Cam, no era.
Came. Yep, came. You came home from school 2 hours ago. Tú viniste a casa de la escuela hace 2 horas, dice. Okay. Simple past. Let's go with the daughter. Well, but my friend Lucy, what do you think? ¿Me llamó o me ha llamado?
Me llamó.
Me llamó. My friend Lucy, simple passive call. My friend Lucy, me llamó, simple pass. What is the pass of call? Necesitan estudiar los verbos. Uh-oh. Simple pass of call. Come on.
Called?
Yes, thank you. Good pronunciation. Called. Okay. Pero mi amiga Lucy me llamó when I... What do you think? Simple past or present perfect?
Simple past.
Simple past, Jesús. It's a regular verb. What is the past of arrive? Only D. Exactly. All right. Let's continue. Well, but my friend Lucy called when I arrived. Bueno, pero mi amiga Lucy me llamó cuando yo llegué, right? And just present perfect. The phone call. Just finished the phone call. ¿Cómo dicen? Y yo justo he terminado. O justo terminé la llamada. What do you think is good? ¿Apenas he terminado? ¿O apenas terminé the phone call? What do you think?
Apenas... terminé.
Apenas terminé. All right. So, simple past. So, you're going to say, I just finished the phone call. Yo apenas terminé. Right? Okay. Let's continue with the mother. Look, in the morning. Simple past or present perfect? Simple past or present perfect? In the morning. What do you think? What do you think? What do you think? Por ejemplo, ahorita, in the morning, is past or is present? In the morning.
Past.
Past. Very good. Okay. It's a question. All right, Jesus. It's a question. What is the auxiliary for past?
Did.
Did. So I'm going to go. The mother, right? Did you? Oh, it's negative. Didn't you? Didn't you see Lucy at school in the morning? ¿Que no viste a Lucy en la escuela en la mañana? Simple past. ¿Que no viste? Didn't you see Lucy at school this morning? All right. Let's go with the daughter. Yes, but look at this one. Entonces, simple past or present perfect? Entonces. Which is referring to the morning, right? The morning. Simple past or present perfect? Then. Como cuando dicen, ah, no puse atención entonces. No puse atención entonces. Simple past or present perfect?
Simple past.
Simple past. Okay. So it's a negative auxiliary for past to make negative. What is it? Simple past, auxiliary, negative. Teacher, si me desconecta, Paulette. Okay, Paulette.
Didn't.
Didn't. Didn't, yes. ¿Qué libro les mandaron? ¿Les mandaron libro estos días? Porque me dice Paulette que también está equivocado su libro. Y pues no es la misma página. Ok, Paulette, it's raining. No tienen esta página. ¿Quién sí tiene esta página?
Me.
Jesús, yes, ok. Angie, you have this page? Evelyn?
Yes.
Yes, ok. Ok. Voy a checar con Andrea.
Teacher.
No sé, según yo, no les mandó otro libro. Mandelina.
Y si nos mandó un libro equivocado, porque la otra vez también nos había mandado otro.
¿Pero cuándo se lo enviaron? No, porque este lo hemos trabajado todo el mes. Ya mañana pasado terminamos libro. Es este, ¿no? ¿Sí? O sea, esta no la tienen.
Había un nuevo libro, creo que no.
No, todavía no. Hasta este fin de semana apenas vamos a cambiar de libro. ¿Esta página sí la tienen?
Yes.
Yes, ok. Y termina aquí, ¿verdad, Jesús? After the castle.
Yes.
Yes. It's confusing. All right. Let's finish. Porque es un tema enfadoso, right? I'm so sorry. So, didn't have. Pero no tuvimos tiempo de hablar entonces, dice ahí. But we didn't have time to talk then. Ok. Entonces, eso es lo que tienen que hacer. Ejercicio number two, exercise number two. Okay. You will work alone. Okay. Alone. Pay attention if the sentence is in simple past or present perfect. Okay. I'm going to help you with specific words. For example, ever. Okay. Last time. Last summer, last summer, okay, everything in passing there, in London, never, okay. Those words are gonna help you to formulate everything in here, okay. Va a ser difícil. Es momento de que empiecen a analizar, ¿ok? Es momento de que empiecen a leer los contextos. Ok, Paulette, don't worry. Okie dokie. All right. 5 minutes, it's good?
Yes.
Yes, ok. Take it easy, okay? Pay attention to the context. There you go.
Teacher, si no tengo el libro, lo hago en una hoja.
Yes, please, Alina. It's possible. There you go. A ver cómo nos va, chicos. Finished. Are we finished? Nadie prendió cámara. Híjuela. Chale. Ready, Angie. Are you ready?
No yet, teacher.
Not yet. Paul, are you finished?
Me faltan cuatro.
Okay. Jesús, finish or not yet?
No, yet.
Right. One, two, three, four, five, six. All right, let's check it out. Let's check them out. What you got for number one? Number one is present perfect because we have ever in here, right? So the correct answer is. What is the correct answer? You got it?
Have you ever been to London?
Have you ever been to London? Have you ever been to London? Very good. That is a correct answer. Have you ever been to London? Letter B. Yes. It's present perfect. Verb to be. What is the answer? This is easy. Positive. But you
I
can.
have been.
Yes, sir. I have been. Thank you. Let's go with number three. Is simple past. Simple past of the verb to be. What you got? When. It's a question. When this is the subject. Verb to be in past. Verb to be in past. Oh, no me fallen aquí, por favor. No, what you got?
Was? Where?
Was, very good. Was in this case. When was the last time? ¿Cuándo fue la última vez? When was the last time? You, verb to be for you, in past, verb to be in past for you. When was the last time you?
Where?
Where? Very good. When was the last time you were there? Okay. Last summer, simple past, verb spent. What you got? Last summer, I.
Spend.
Simple passive spend. Very good. Last summer, I spent 2 weeks in Brinkton with my parents. And we, simple past, go. And we
went
to London 1 weekend. Question, you like it? In simple past, what is the auxiliary for simple past? Did you like it? Oh, did you like it? That's the question. ¿Te gustó? Did you like it? Oh, yes. We really, present perfect, have.
Had.
We really had. En realidad tuvimos un gran tiempo en London. Excuse me, sorry. And to finish, lucky you is negative. Never to London. Present perfect.
I have never been.
I have never been. There you go. Thank you very much. Ahí está. How many good ones you obtain? How many good ones? We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Out of 9. Jesus, how many correct ones you got?
9.
9. Very good, Mr. Paul.
7,
very good too. Alina, how many?
8.
8. Angie, how many, Angie?
8.
8 also. And Evelyn?
7.
7 out of 9. Excellent. But there you go. Tomorrow we're going to continue with this. I'm sorry. All right. See you tomorrow. Thank
Goodbye.
You guys.
See you tomorrow.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Bye bye.
Goodbye.
Bye bye.